Hello from our final morning in Sapphire Falls for Brennan's birthday staycation. I'm heading down to the pool to go down the water slide.
So the fourth floor is where the lobby is. That's where I just came from. The second floor is where the pool is, which is where I'm heading. And then the first floor right down there, that's where Amatista is, the restaurants. And then the water taxi boat launch over to City Walk. All right, so I just came outside. You have to use your key card to gain access into the pool area. But over here are the waterfalls. There's the bridge that Brennan and I saw the torrential downpour yesterday. I think I'm gonna go down over here by the waterfalls just to see the view. That's where I just came from, right up there, and here's the very bottom of the accessible area over by the waterfalls. I think it's Amatista straight ahead, right over there, which is where we'd like to have breakfast. There's the boat launch, the water parks, and to City Walk, there are the waterfalls, and then there's the lobby right up there. I really wanted to come check this out before we left. I was so disappointed when we weren't able to yesterday due to the rain. Right now Brennan is back in the room getting ready, so I'm gonna go and head over to the pool just for a quick trip down the water slide. The water taxi just arrived and the pool did literally just open, so there shouldn't be a lot of people over here. I don't think that there will be, but I'm heading directly over to the pool to go ahead and slide down that and then back up to the room so we can gather our belongings and then head over to Amatista, hopefully to have some breakfast. See how quiet it is over here right now? All right, so there are a few people using the pool this morning. This is a zero entry pool, which is really nice. I'm over by the fire pits and I believe the hot tub right over there, but that is the water slide, so that's where I'm heading. This is what I'm about to do right here. I think I have to pass underneath the cave over here to get to the other side where the stairs are, but I have my GoPro right here, so I'm just gonna go ahead and set my camera down, hop over the GoPro, and then go down the slide. And hello from my GoPro, here are the slide rules, and I'm heading right up the ramp to the very top to go ahead and go down that slide. I think I'm just gonna do it once so I can head back to the room. Well, it's getting progressively busier right over there. I'm heading across the bridge here. This is the cavern that I had to go through just to get to the other side of the pool. And I'm almost at the top to ride the slide. Okay, so I did not need to go through the cave because there are stairs right over here next to the hot tub to get it to the top to ride the slide. There's the pool right there, and then this is quite hilarious. The slide is not even open right now. It is locked, and you can't get on the slide. The slide is running, but I guess there's nobody up here to operate the slide for whatever reason. So no slide for me today. Well, of course, as soon as I make it back down to my belongings and I'm about to head back up to the room, a lifeguard goes up and opens up the water slide, so I'm gonna go ahead and try this again. See, this is more like it. The gate is open and the water slide is accessible. Woo!
Okay, it's a little cold. What an adventure this is, right?
All right, I did it. There were the Sapphire Falls water slide. It's a little bit longer than I anticipated, but it was fun. But now it's time to head back to the room to grab all of our belongings and head off to the car to put them in the car in the parking garage. All right, I'm back at my regular camera. Now heading back up to the room. I'm really glad that I got to have that experience at the pool because I always want to try to go to the pool whenever I get to stay at a resort. It just really makes that experience worth it. All right, so I made it back up to the room. We are all packed up and ready to go. Hello?
Hi.
You're a very dark but beautiful silhouette right now. So we're gonna head down to the car to put our belongings into the car and see if we have time for breakfast at Amatista. But if not, then we'll probably get breakfast somewhere else.
Yes.
Okay, so we're heading down to Amatista. We put all of our luggage into the car. You don't handle the big steps?
No.
No. So let's see if they have some availability. If not, then we'll see what else we can do. All right, so we are inside Amatista, which is a breakfast buffet bar. But I'm gonna head to the buffet and have ourselves some delicious looking breakfast over here. And now it's my turn. All right, so I just went up to the buffet and look what I got. I pretty much got absolutely everything. So I got a donut there. I got a ton of different fruit. I got some bacon, I got some sausage, I got some pancakes back there, got a cinnamon roll, got some hash browns there with a biscuit, got some cheese, grits, and then I made an omelet with pretty much everything that they had up there. Ham, bacon, cheese, spinach, tomatoes, onions, mushrooms, salsa. This is gonna be absolutely incredible. I am so excited. Look at all of this food. Okay, so we just finished up with breakfast inside Amatista. That was phenomenal. This is one of my favorite places in any resort to have breakfast. All right, and after slowly waddling up the stairs, back up to the lobby, we are finally heading back to the car to go pick up our puppy.
Yay, it's puppy time.
Here's the lobby right over here. Right across the street is Aventura. And then we parked way down at the very end, right down there in the parking garage. Hello, so I have not shown myself at all in the video yet today. So here I am
This was an incredible stay. We're going to wrap it up, obviously, a little bit later after we head back home. I think the only demerit of today's trip was just our view outside of our room.
Yeah.
Obviously, we absolutely enjoyed staying in Sapphire Falls. We love staying here, but just that view of the lagoon or the theme park or the pool, it's just really what makes this day just absolutely perfect, I think.
I think for me, it just made me feel excluded from the rest of the resort.
You think so?
Yeah, because there was no like life going on outside the window, which is what we're used to. We're either used to seeing people come off the water taxi or used to seeing people in the pool.
But regardless, goodbye, Sapphire Falls. We had a good time, and we'll be back soon. We're gonna go pick up a puppy now. And this concludes Brennan's birthday weekend at Sapphire Falls.
Yay.
We picked up Arlo from her parents' house.
Yay.
Look at this face. Oh my god, he needs a haircut really bad.
Oh yeah.
Did you have fun?
I did. I had a great weekend.
It was such a relaxing stay. We just checked in on that first day and we just kind of enjoyed our time in the room. And then the next day we went into the parks and we had our little scavenger hunt. And then we went to Horror Nights that night. And then we went to Volcano Bay the next day. And then we had an evening at City Walk that evening, and then we checked out today. I got to go to the pool. It was such a big weekend.
That's what I like doing about the long stays is that, you know, you can have that first night to just chill and do absolutely nothing because it's about, like, relaxing and catching up with yourself and then still having the rest of the weekend to do all the other fun stuff that we did.
And we'll absolutely be back, and I think I already said that the only really just demerit, if you want to call it that, was just our view. We've had a good amount of different views of during our stay, I guess, at Sapphire Falls, of just the resort and the lagoon and the theme parks. But we'll be back for sure.
This is one of my birthday presents from Roy.
This is. I got her a little side of plush. I made her an Arlo shirt. I also made this right back here.
Yes, remember when I made this for Roy for, what was it, Christmas?
I think so.
I made him the Farley Pokemon. He finally made the Arlo Pokemon.
So now we just need Calvin, and then we'll have our little animals as Pokemon. I also got, we've been on a Pokemon binge, obviously, both of us. I got her involved in it now.
No, and I'm obsessed with Psyduck now.
Do you remember when, for April Fool's, I said, this is gonna be a Pokemon channel? Just kidding. It's
really
not a Pokemon channel.
You really didn't mean it at the time.
I'm just indulging in a side hobby.
We both kind of just like dove right into the Pokemon craze.
It's
we're
just
both
fun.
In it.
I know, right? Like, I even got the Pokemon Oreos, which we still need to try. Didn't have a chance to try those at the resorts. I got this up in, I guess, North Carolina. This is a Pokemon Elite Trainer box. And then I got Brennan for her birthday.
I got
her this one. So she's going to be opening up this one
tonight,
super soon. This is the alternative version of it. But I guess as far as our little staycation, we had a great time. And we'll absolutely, hopefully, be doing it again. It was a blast, right? Well, happy birthday.
Thank you.
Okay. And now I get to go to Texas, which is going to be fun. I'm going to meet up with my brothers there and go to a little financial conference. So I'll see you right after that. We're coming up on the 50th anniversary of Magic Kingdom and Walt Disney World. That'll be a blast. So a lot of fun stuff in the future.
Yeah.
All right. We'll see you soon. Have a great day. Thanks for watching. And goodbye.
Bye. Psyduck.